What's up, everybody? You already know it's your boy Freddie Yo, and I got your MJ stock update for the day, August 24th. And I got some feedback at the end on Afria. What's going on today? What I read yesterday that was very interesting by the Motley Fool report. And notice, guys, Motley Fool stepping up their game. I think Afria is gonna blow pretty soon, or MJ sector in general. But guys, make sure before I give you this content that you give me a like if you love the content. And if you guys want to see these updates more often, I will be giving my opinion and all the information that I read or find online or wherever on MJ stocks to let you know. I'll keep you up to date. So if you could subscribe so you get that up-to-date content. But here we go, guys. Before I give you that Motley Fool report, let me tell you what the MJ stocks are looking like today. It was a green day. It was the stocks were green today for a couple stocks. I have a feeling it has to do a lot to do with the U.S. election coming up. I think a lot of people are believing that Joe Biden is going to win. Sorry, Republicans, if that offends you, but it's gonna be very beneficial for the marijuana market. So I think people are slowly gonna start putting their money in. But here we go. Let's start with Cronos. Cronos right now is sitting at $5.58, up 18 cents for the day, which is good. Good for you, Cronos. And down for the day only 1 cent, for a total for the whole day of 3.1% upside for Cronos. So if you made a little money today, if you bought when they were going down, you just made some money going up. You know what I mean? Might be time to get out. Let's go. Moving on. ACB right now is sitting at $9.55. Oh yeah, guys, I got Freddie O with me. It's sitting at $9.55, up 10 cents for the day. And also, after hours, ACB was up 4 cents for a total today of being up 1.5%. Way to go, ACB. You know, you guys are hanging in there, I guess, you know. Good for you guys. Moving on, we got Hexo. Hexo right now is sitting at 69 cents. Down only half a penny, or, you know, I guess that's a lot if you only worth 69 cents a share. So, yeah, half a penny during the day, and down another penny, or half a penny after hours, down a total of 1.5% for the day. Or, you know, 1 cent for the whole day. Buffy, you're going down. Say bye to Freddie O. Bye bye. Thank you for your time, Papa. Go play. Thank you. Okay, sorry about that, guys. Moving on, guys, we got Canopy Growth. Canopy Growth right now is sitting at $16.38. All right, Canopy made their shareholders some money today. It was up 41 cents for the day. Wow, that's a good chunk of money. After hours, down 5 cents. Obviously, we know shorts got their money and ran right there. Okay, but for the day, at the end of the day, Canopy Growth is up for the whole day, 2.25%. Good for you guys, man. What's up? Organigram, here we go. Organigram, dun dun dun. Organigram is that scary place, man. They are sitting right now at $1.28, down another penny for the day. Okay, only 1 penny, and flat after hours. Okay, and for a total loss today, Organigram, not that much, only 0.78%, not even a whole percent, 0.75%, you know. Moving on, guys, we got Tilray. Tilray sitting at $6.74, up 10 cents for the day, flat after hours. And for a total of upside, boom, 1.51%. We got Tilray sitting at. Moving on, guys. The king, you guys already know, Afria. Afria right now is sitting at $4.51, okay? Up 7 cents. Afria went up 7 cents today. And then came back down 4 cents after hours. For a total of being up today, Afria 0.7%, or 0.75%. Okay, and that's where the stocks are sitting. Like I said, everything was mainly green today for the stocks. But So unless your name is Organigram, Hexo, and yeah, that's about it. The other stocks did pretty damn good. But let's go, guys. I'm here to talk about the Motley Fool report today that that came out August 23rd. Today is August 24th. I don't do on Sundays because it's not stock market day. So I read the report yesterday, and I'm doing a story today, August 24th. It's called the only cannabis stock I'd buy today. Aphria, obviously. And the author of this report through the Motley Fool is Amy Lejate Wolf. I hope I said that right. Give me some credit. Amy Lejate Wolf. If I said your name right, yo, you come back on this and you'd be like, yo, he's dope. That guy, he's the real deal. Okay, can I try? Okay? And by the way, guys, I will leave the link at the bottom with this Motley Fool report so you guys can see everything in detail. But I'm only going to summarize the stuff that I found of importance, all the stuff that we've already heard before. I skip all that stuff. You know what I mean. All right, here we go, guys. Like I said, her title of the report is Aphria, the only stock I'd buy today, okay? She starts by saying, a year ago, Aphria wasn't her favorite stock. You know what I mean? That was what she started her introduction with. And she says a lot of people weren't like that. And me personally, Aphria wasn't on the top of my list either. I was in ACB. I was in Kronos a lot, heavy. But I'm not as much anymore or at all. So I agree with her. I wasn't thinking Aphria a year ago. You know what I mean? And then she spoke of how Aphria, the last three consecutive quarters, EBITDA, that Aphria is doing and turning a profit. We all know that stuff. We all know that Aphria is doing that. So it didn't, that's why I went quick through that, because we all know that Aphria is doing that stuff. Every report is saying the same thing. But I'm trying to show you the things that, were of importance. She goes, after talking about the EBITDA, she spoke of how cannabis stocks, how they are affected by the coronavirus, by basically saying everybody took a hit because of the coronavirus. Every single pot stock, you know what I mean? Even Aphria. Aphria took a hit, it affected them. But out of everybody, Aphria, she says, is the only one that's still stable. And that's a big deal, guys. She's saying that. Hopefully the world is seeing that. Motley Fool is world renowned, man. I hope she breaks through and people invest in Aphria, guys. Money. I always say, you know what I mean? I got bills and stuff. I got vacations I want to take. Help me out, Aphria. Make us all happy people. Okay. And then she goes into why Aphria right now, the stock is actually cheap. And this is really interesting what she says. She says it's because they haven't bought in to the U.S. yet. Not because, Aphria is doing bad or something. It's because they haven't bought in. Canopy Growth, I think, bought in. Kronos is already in. That's why they're still slightly ahead of us. I think Tilray's, I'm not sure if they're in, but they might be already in the USA. And that's what she says. That's why Aphria is low. But then she goes into detail about how, think about it, Aphria has the opportunity to do something great. You know what I mean? Aphria has $500 million that they can put into the U.S. and do what they have to do and get into the market the right way. We're already leading in Canada. Imagine if we do it the right way and we lead in USA too. And hopefully Canada was the blueprint. And like I always say, quality is the most important thing, and Aphria does quality. And then she spoke, my bad guys. She speaks about how Aphria are gonna do it, and she basically broke down CC Pharma. CC Pharma didn't, back in the day, used to sell cannabis, but Aphria bought them. They got into the cannabis game, and they got the license in Europe to sell cannabis, and then they turned 13,000 pharmacies into cannabis dispensary pharmacies. Isn't that freaking cool? So I think that's what they're gonna do in the U.S. Maybe they're not, because they said they're not gonna just straight up or start a pot company or a marijuana or a cannabis company and then pay that premium. They want to do what CC Pharma did. They want to buy the company first. It's not even medically legal federally. We get the all the federal locations, 50 states, have our pharmacies there, and then boom, once it goes federal for medical, recreation, whatever, we're already there. Boom. We don't have to pay that price you pay to start off. You already have your business. Boom. And after it says they want to start building before, you know, just in preparation, and the day that hits, boom, Afria's ready to go, and we already got the best product in Canada. I'm sure they smoke a lot more than Americans do, because they got it legal and everything, so I'm sure they know what's the good product. Imagine when that good product comes to the United States. Lastly, guys, she leaves us with a cherry on top, guys, with a cherry on top. She says, she leaves us with her potential prediction upside, and she predicts $22 a share upside, and a future 250% upside from where we're sitting right now at 450, guys. Damn. I hope we have a Tesla moment or Apple moment. You know what I mean? Afria deserves it. Yeah. Yes, guys. But that is it for today. That is my report for you guys, and my daily update on the stocks. You know what I mean? Like I always say, guys, please, if you love this content, like and subscribe for your boy. And I'm going to keep it going. I'll keep you guys posted. Check the report out. I got the link at the bottom. There's a lot of good content that I left out. You know what I mean? I'm just a guy giving my own opinion. You know what I mean? Check it out for yourself, guys. And shout out to all my Afria crew, everybody who's invested in Afria. Let's make that money.